Angels in America. 20 years since you first put it on stage.
I'm old.
Yes.
I was young when I first came on the show.
What is it about it that you think has so resonated?
I think it's, you can interpret it in a number of different ways. So I think it can be read as a very political play. Harold Bloom thinks it's a theological play.
Yeah.
I think when Mike Nichols made the film version of it, he really read it in a very specific, as a very specific personal drama. And I think you can take it in different ways, and I think that's helped it survive. Apparently, it has a lot of appeal to young people. It's taught in colleges a lot, and that's given it a long life, I think. And I think it's, you know, connected to a moment, a watershed moment in history. It didn't in any way create that moment, but I mean, it arrived just at the point at which the country was beginning to get ready, or was actually beginning to face up to what had happened in the 80s with the epidemic. There's a fantastic documentary, it's nominated for an Oscar, called How to Survive a Plague. It's just a brilliant history of ACT UP and the Treatment Action Group, which is a subset of ACT UP, and how that they really very scrupulously parse how ACT UP changed the nature of the face of the epidemic, the nature of the epidemic. But it's, you know, those times, which seem very distant now, you know, the country did not face up to its responsibility. And Angels arrived at a moment when it was starting to take stock of that. And also people needed a place to mourn. And it was there's a certain amount of grieving in the play.
And it was a play you had to write.
Yeah, I mean, it was, or I guess it was the play I wrote.
Yeah.